Hi everybody, welcome to another how-to video with Kodaster and Salome Mecca. And today I want to talk about linear dynamic analysis with modal basis. So building up on the last how-to video that I made, that was about linear dynamic analysis of a simple model. This was the last video on our YouTube channel. My intention is now to show you how we can consider a modal basis, so the modal shapes of the structure, and do the linear dynamic analysis with these modal shapes. This will bring a significant reduction of the execution time, and as long as the mod shapes are, you have the correct number of mod shapes, everything will be the same. You will not lose any accuracy. So let's jump on the code that we have to follow for this. On the right, it is the new case, this case with the modal base. On the left, it is the initial case with the full analysis of the structure. So it doesn't change much. I just want to show also a comparison of the commands. If we go on the right and we see the command file, we have some initial variables. We have the model, everything as we did before. We have the element properties. So if you did not see the video of the model analysis, I think it is better to see that video and then come to this. We have the properties of the elements, the cell elements, the beam elements. We have the materials, the support conditions, the weight, and then we were also extracting the mass for each element, and we were exporting this to our resu result file. Then we have assemblage, that is again the same as before. As you can see, as up to here we have exactly the same code, and here we are assembling the stiffness and the mass matrix of the structure, and we calculate the modes. I'm going to consider 10 modes, since it's a structure of two stories, so 10 modes is more than enough. And we are exporting also these modes, so we have exactly the same up to this point. Exporting the results in a table and exporting the displacements that we can see in ParaView. Now we come to the next step, where we have to define the time of our analysis. Now in this case, in the first case, we were doing a static analysis of the gravity load, and we were assigning this as an initial part of initial state of the model. When we use this modal basis model, we cannot do this, so we can only accept another dynamic analysis concept. So we have to apply the gravity load through a dynamic analysis, and the typical way that I do this is that I consider 1 second, so from -1 to 0 is the analysis where I'm going to apply the load, typically with a ramp load, and then from 0 to my final time I have the analysis as I did before. I'm also, so this is the analysis for the gravity load. This is the standard analysis with the time step that I have defined. And we define another concept, which is a time step that I want to archive. So I'm not registering all the file, all the analysis steps. I'm using 1000 steps per second, and I'm going to archive 100 steps per second. So I create this other concept that I'm going to tell him that to extract only in these time steps. This is the ramp function for the load application. So we say that starts from minus 1 to 0, goes from 0 to 1. And then we continue with the typical concepts for the acceleration as we did before. This doesn't change. Up to this point, nothing really changed. Nothing new. Now, we see here the new concepts. We have another assemblage. This is another assembly where we don't use the matrix assembly, but the vector assembly. Now, this we have to do it for every load that we're going to consider. So, as you can see here, we had the acceleration loads. And it is creating another concept. So here we have to tell him which load we want to consider. We have the weight and the two acceleration loads. We have to tell him that is a mechanical load, and then we have to give him the concept of that is going to return. So as you know, this means that then we're going to have a variable called axf underscore xv in this case. So I'm using the same name with a v for the vector, and this is assembling a vector array in our model for so that we can apply it in our analysis. And this is just an assembly, and then we start with the model base in this command. And as you can see, we could also define this in our first assemblage, but we did not. So one can use the same command here and, for example, do this vect assay, but we did not. We could not calculate these concepts because we need the mass matrix. As you can see, we have the mass matrix that is defined in the directions. Okay. Probably we could. So we have the direction that needs the mass matrix. Then we can define this concept of the acceleration that we need in the assemblage. So we cannot make it in one assemblage. We have to do twice the assemblage. Just to note here, for example, that here for this the number of degrees of freedom, we are using the concept that we extracted in the previous assemblage. So now you can understand what is this. But I didn't understand also when I was using CodeAstain in the beginning. So here you get this that you can reuse your next, let's say, analysis, next concepts. So let's go to prods base. This is the main command that is going to define our model. And exactly, it is similar to assemblage. So we have to tell him what is the base. So it is the modes that we calculated. And then what matrices and what vectors we want to assemble. So this is a generalized, say, assembly. And we are going to give him a matrix, the stiffness matrix and mass matrix. I'm using this underscore g, take back the concepts, and the same for the vectors. You have the two accelerations plus the weight. The type of vector is force, and we are getting back the concepts. When we did that, we are good to go with the analysis. So first we do a gravity analysis. Let's see what are the differences in DynaVibra. So DynaVibra is a general operator, as you can see, you can use it for the transient analysis if the type of calcul is tran, or for the harmonic analysis if you use harm. And then we have the base of a calcul or the calculation. Here we have a physical base in the first example, Here we're going to use a generalized base. As you can see, we don't need anymore the element properties, the material properties, the model. We just need the new matrices. We need the excitation. And in the excitation, I think that this is mandatory or can be a coefficient, a real coefficient. You cannot just put the weight as the load as here. But this you can see it if you want to play around. And we have the increments that we want to do the analysis, the schema tapes. These are the, so optional. And we have also the modal dumping. As before, it is in this case we have to define a modal dumping, either a single value that will go to all the modes or a value for all the modes. In this case, I'm using 20% modal dumping only for this, to so as to mitigate the effect of the static of the gravity load. Essentially, we want to, when we finish this analysis, we don't want any vibration remaining from the application of gravity loads. Since we are using a ramp load, this will not be the case even if we didn't have so that much dumping. I did some tests. I saw that with this dumping, we could also apply the load without a ramp load. Just run this 1 second with dumping that is would reduce the vibration to zero. In any case, I'm doing both, let's say, approaches. And this is the gravity load. So after the gravity load, we can do the main analysis. We are using the initial state, and we are referencing the gravity analysis. This is the initial state. And we have the weight, always. This, as we said, remains after zero, remains equal to one. We have this cos and rho constant, so it's a constant value after. We have the three loads, and I'm using the damping here that is 5% for all 10. For all 10 modes. Here I was using only in the first 5, so essentially I could also make a list where I would have the first 5 values would be 0.05 and the other would be 0. But I would have to have a list of 10. Now this analysis has only the essentially is solving a system of 10 degrees of freedom. 10 degrees of system of, let's say, 10 models of 10 single degree of freedom models. And then we have to pre-construct the displacements, acceleration, whatever we want in back to the full structure if we want to have the results, to plot the results, etc. So this is the final command that is important in order to arrive to the same result. So we are restituting back from the generalized to the physical base. We're going to tell him that we need only the acceleration and the displacement. So here we can select also the velocity, whatever. This is the generalized result. In what instances we want to take the response? So here we are doing the archive operation, whereas in the other part we had a dedicated keyword inside the main command. And then we were using this because when we did the gravity analysis, that was from minus 1 to 0, the due to numerical, let's say, reasons, numerical differences, we don't have a result at zero exactly. It is a very, very small number, but it is different at zero. And if we don't include this, we will get an error, you can try it, that we don't have the result at the time equals zero that we are requesting take. You can't have a precision, is like a tolerance, about as a tolerance and with an absolute criterion. Once we have this, everything is again the same. So we are extracting some displacements, we're calculating displacements at the roof in one direction, in the other direction, and the mean displacements, and we are calculating everything in the table, and we are importing this table. And also we have the result. So we can go and see these tables very quickly. Okay, the displacement here, you can see what I was talking about before. It is not zero, but it's zero. We have also the model analysis, the masses. And of course, we can go always to our Jupyter Lab notebook, and which is also in the code that I provide. We can run, we can see this is our the acceleration time histories, and this is our displacement time histories. This is from the model and model base, from the physical base. And if we go to see the maximum displacements, we can see that we are very, very, very close. So very, very, very small differences. Also, let's see. In ParaView, I have done this this plotting just to show that two objects moving exactly the same. And this is what I wanted to show. I don't think that there is anything else. Just let's go over also the export file, how you can do this in ASTK or of course in Salomeca. I have provided the export file in this case. You can have the input. This is the med that we use. These are the two acceleration time histories are with this med. Have the two acceleration time histories. Let me see something else. This is unit 2. Acceleration time histories, the message file, then we have the model analysis result with 80, we have the dynamic analysis result with 81, then we have the model analysis text result with 10, and the seismic with 11. So if you use the file that I provide, you have to make sure that you have this unit correct. Otherwise, also in Salomeca, you have to be consistent. This is all I wanted to talk about. I hope this is an interesting topic. For sure, being able to reduce the analysis time is important, especially for linear analysis. You don't actually need either all the freedom. It makes lot of sense to use it. Thank you, and see you in the next video. Have a good day.